our dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 38 in our series, Create a RubyGem, Nerd Dice. So in our last episode, we wrote a spec for our Nerd Dice die class. We're going to keep that in progress because I anticipate we might need to tweak it a bit as we go and work on our actual class to get it to pass. So I've already realized one thing that I want to do is make an assertion about the value returned in that. Die roll method, so it turns the new value do and call it roll value equals roll and then expect to equal die dot value. So I want to check two things are happening here, that the die value is being changed and that it's returning the new value that it's providing. So now we'll go in and create our die class here. We need to, you can see, and I'll just do it. We're gonna fail here because we haven't required the directory, and we haven't put anything in the file. So we want, similar to before, this needs to be in the nerd dice module. And then we'll create the comments and everything later. Let's just see if we can. This is still going to fail with the same message because we haven't required the file. An initialize constant. So now we're going to go into nerd dice, just like we required nerd dice configuration. Nerd dice die. Now we've got new failures. We'll isolate our specs too. To the die spec here. So everything's failing. Wrong number of arguments, given one expected zero, so we don't have our initialize method implemented yet. So that's the first thing that we've got to do. So we'll go to our die method here. This will be a private method. Get an argument error anymore. Now I'll get errors about the undefined method. and two, expected one. Undefined methods, so we don't have our everything's failing as we should expect because we haven't really done anything yet. Okay, so the options we actually not put in a hash. Probably going to make RuboCop angry. Documentation comment. That's the only thing that we've got going wrong right now, so we'll take it. Let's run specs again. Oops. Run the subset of specs. So now we're getting undefined methods and all these things, which is good. So we'll start with all right. So number of sides equals number of sides. Inside the class. So that's the number of sides from the first argument is passing. So we have 13 examples, 11 failures. Making progress. Generator override. Go to our in here. Need to, that'll be generator override, and we're gonna create a generator override equals method. Similar to what we did in configuration. sure I'm spelling override correctly. Yep, that's two R's everywhere. We want to actually use the spelled correctly in spec. It is not. Just do good old control H. Alright. So this can be nil, so val you. Oh, and I'm going to call these all new value since I'm going to have a value. Failures. Alright. Has the expected default generator of nil. It did not. Providing that in spell it correctly. It should not have been nil though, it should have errored out. Still 10. Some puts statements here. I might be failing to dereference it properly. Let's see here. Oops. No, it seemed to work. There. Let's just die with options. Let's focus on line 40. Got a failure. failure. Example here. So it gave us options come in as in add new value. Didn't call generator override equals. At least it doesn't look like it did. All right. Options. Again, no, still, I didn't control H it here. Not even calling it. This is going to potentially make it pass. Yeah, that made it pass. So I guess you have to have the thing fully instantiated to get it to pass. Another new private method. 9 failures. Here. And for now, we're just going to make these constants. We'll iterate on this later. And we'll make them equal to what we want in our defaults. That's our foreground. Our background. Still 9 failures. We need a attribute. Here. An attribute accessor for background color and foreground color. Down to 5 failures. Related to die.roll. So we're going to create a value will be a reader. Value equals execute die or nerd dice. Well, we'll see if it requires me to namespace it, since it inherits. And then execute die roll. still have 5 failures. Actually, I wonder if I can do self. Two failures. So we have errors on 24 and 53. Oh, because I never set the value. There we go. So we've got passing specs. Let's run the whole suite. Suite is passing. Redundant return. Two line after guard clause. So we'll autocorrect those. Down to one. One error, which is our lack of our comment here. I also want to do one more spec here. Done this before. That's the exact same error. How about that? All right, let's see. Failed here. the spec. Rerun the spec. Still failing. Space that. Still not working. Check, make sure it raises the error at all. Still failing. Oh, I bet I need it in a block. I do need it in a block. That's my problem. Back to RoboCop. Alright, auto correct that. Alright, so now we just need our comment at the top of the class. So I'll pause and write that. So I've got my class introduction comment. RoboCop is now okay. RSpec is okay. So let's try committing and pushing this to our branch. working directory is clean. We'll rebase and reword our commit. Right now, we'll just do a pick and a fix up, and then I'll commit amend. And so let's do git commit amend sign it. We'll make the date now. So we've got our message, sign it. Now we'll try pushing it to our branch. We'll check on our actions. While we're doing that, I'm going to add a few items to our backlog that came up during those last couple of videos. So I've got two new methods here. So update the changelog and readme. Put that under the dice set class. And then this came up earlier, so we don't want to have a constant for our background and foreground colors. We want to modify the configuration object to use those. Check on our action. Oh, we failed. Let's see what happened. Benchmark failed. So that was a small fractional failure on the benchmark. I'll just go in and increase the ratio there. Push it. Oh, that reminds me, we want to also create a item here. Move that down before the changelog and readme. Check on our action. It is now passing. So we'll stop there. Pick things up next.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.